I'm Nadhir. I am an illustrator, but I also like to try to tell stories in whatever mediums I do. So it can be paintings, it can be an art book, and it can also be even pattern designs. I like exploring like usually mundane things, which are like humans and also like plants. And then like, how do I relate it back to fantastical things or mythology? When we look back into like folklores and mythology, they always have this beautiful marriage of like things they are not supposed to be together. The idea of actually combining things is how you make, you know, something new. And yeah, if you don't combine things, then you're just gonna be a copy instead of like a whole new thing. So I think it is a very important process for every artist. My Segan is actually an extension of Segan, which is the original series based on my stay at Rimundahan, which is an art residency. It explores more about like quietness and being passive and how do we use that, you know, to progress instead of letting it hold us back. So all of the series, I mean, all of the works that I did, like the series, it explores on that, you know, like the relationship between being passive and also it, like with potentials and with growth. So yeah, that's what Segan is all about. I mean, I feel like I've been doing a lot of different things. Like I started from pencils and then I picked up a digital tablet and then so I explored more on that. But for my residency at Rimundahan, I tried to explore watercolors because I wanted to try something new. For example, I did like a modern magic, which is an art book that I did. So this one I used mostly on my tablet. So for Masis again, as you guys can see, like there are a lot of like plants and then there are like people hidden in the little places in between the plants and nature. So I was very inspired about that. You know, like plants and like nature, they had always been there with us like as human beings, like since the, you know, like the dawn of time. So I wanted to explore like, you know, emotions or stories in little things that is that had always been a part of our life. There's no like a binding contract to what time or what timeline are they in. So that's why I chose plants to explore my subjects. I think for the local scene, even though we did have like a very particular stroke that is very familiar to everyone, like that really speaks loudly as a Malaysian style. We might not have like an obvious Malaysian stroke, but then the stories that we tell are very like Nusantara, or you know, like we don't have to see the same way of how we talk about Hang Tua or how we talk about Pontianak. And I do see a lot of you know, like young artists who are exploring all of these things not in the usual Malaysian way. And I mean, of course, I feel like it's very normal for people to want to like gatekeep or like to want to stress out so much about the things that we are used to, but then it's such a thing for artists too to, you know, like reinterpret things that are familiar, which is our like Malaysians, Nusantara, and then like to come up with new styles to tell them. So I feel like it doesn't necessarily have to be sad, like we should celebrate, like, you know, like reclaiming our roots. I think it is an interesting time to see how Malaysian artists explore our own style, yeah.